So I'm going on a little quest for waves. I've just done a couple of hours work in the morning and to be honest I can't focus anymore. It's been howling really, really windy for the last 3 days, like bang onshore westerly, and I'm just checking out the beach to see if I can find a bit of a spot with a bit of shelter to get out. But I'm going on a little quest to find some waves this afternoon, and I've got a paddle to have a look at and have a go on as well, so an RD paddle, so I'm going to give that a go as well. Let's just pull this over and see if this beach is not working. I'll show you this. Windy, onshore, 300 mile paddle. It's quite far. In fact, it looks absolutely horrible. So no, let's go somewhere else. Let's see what we can find. I think it's gotta be 30 knots out there today. It's freaking windy. So beggars can't be choosers on a day like today. It's not too cold. Guys, don't know what the UK temperature's like. It's getting on there. It's November. Water temperature's about 13 degrees. Still in a 4.3 suit, so it's not too bad. But yeah, it's sun's out, so can't complain too much. But we still get plenty of waves. And I have to say, hopefully where I'm going today, there will be nobody there. Right, I'm on the walk now through a really nice, I love walking through the woods to the beach. Not loads of places in the world you can do it, but when you come across a break through the woods, I think it's really magical. I can hear it, can't see it, don't think it's going to be that big, maybe shoulder high. It's basically over a rocky slabby sort of break. It's not super full on, pretty sketchy, just got to sit with the boils in the water, but I like that sort of thing. One word of warning, I don't want to be like a party pooper, but if you are going on a little mini mission like this, maybe don't tell your other surf mates if you want to keep it a secret, but you know, tell somebody where you're going. I just send them a text message when I get just about to go out and when I'm back, because nobody would find me if something went wrong, and if there's nobody else there, then definitely nobody would find you. So it's just a good thing to do, just in case. Oh man, this is brambly way. Right? 10-minute walk, and very muddy feet. I'm sorry to do this to you guys, but we're gonna have to have GoPro footage of this. I personally hate it, but it's better than nothing, eh?
Understand that you got something with you. Ass is fat, frame is little.
had a few good ones actually. Nothing epic, like maybe head high on the set, maybe. Quite sunny. If you guys haven't had any, done any reef surfing before, obviously you've got to be super, super careful. But a telltale to where to take off, look for the boils, look for the sort of suctions underwater that are rising up, and that's where the wave's going to take off and hit first because it's shallower. Yeah, so look for the boils, and then the problem with that when you're paddleboarding, especially on a smaller board, is that they're really sucky and really moving. It's really hard to stay upright. So, but if you look for them, that is where to take off. Wave coming. A bit closer in there then. Right, let me just try and show you a boil. Show you what a boil looks like, just in case you don't know. If you do know, just ignore me. There's one. Watch out for this wave. Now? Yeah. It's like a big circle of water. Well, and that's it. Walk back to the car now. Pretty nice little small session. Nice to get out. Nobody out. Just you guys. Hope you enjoyed it. If not, there's loads of other stuff to watch on SUPboarder. Techniques, reviews, and also SUPboarder Pro, which we go into techniques and reviews in a lot more detail. See you next time. Cheers.